Hi guys, it's Jen and welcome to another Mindset Monday where we set healthy and positive intentions and mindset shifts for the week so that we can spend more time feeling happy and less time feeling stuck. So today is a bit of a deep topic, so let's dive right in. I've met a lot of people in my life that are really, really miserable in their life because they just feel like they get the short end of the stick every time, all the time. This toxic mindset is a true stealer of joy and a quicksand pit that will swallow you up and hold on to you for a really, really long time. I've found that some of the biggest lies that you tell yourself when you're in this toxic mindset is that, number one, everything and everyone has screwed you over. Number two, the universe, the government, your job, school, whatever, owes you X, Y, and Z because of all the things you've been through. And number three, this is why I can't get ahead in life. Ever. Ever. So today I'm gonna give you a mindset shift that you can start making that will help you be happier and get you unstuck from this really toxic mindset trap. And it's that most things in life are a domino effect. The choices you make and the habits that you cultivate lead you to where you are and can dictate the outcome of your life. You know that quote that we hear all the time? You can't see change, you can't make change if you do the same thing over and over again. That applies here. If you're unhappy about a certain area of your life, identify where you need to make the change and start taking action and take ownership of that change. Maybe you have a damaged relationship because you don't know how to handle conflict. A lot of times that comes from not being able to manage your feelings and emotions. So start there. Perhaps you're unhappy with the state of your health or your appearance. Identify a habit that prevents you from being the person that you want to be or feeling the way that you want to feel. Identify a habit that prevents you from feeling better about yourself. Once you start recognizing how your habits are holding you back or affecting your life, that's when you can start making the changes towards breaking free. You can shed that cycle of negative behavior and negative self-talk and begin to move forward. In any area of life, giving someone else the power over your situation by putting the blame on them or on the system without recognizing the role that you play in that scenario is not only the easy way out, it's the grip that squeezes opportunity and growth out of your life. Instead of blaming your situation on someone else's brokenness, someone else's greed, and their ineptitude, take ownership of how you ended up there, whether you had a choice in it or not, and then let it go. Don't drag it along with you. The way I like to look at it is if you look at all of life's experiences and put that blame and negativity first and base all of your life circumstances on that blame, you're gonna have a mountain of negative blame that you are buried under. So you've got this depressing pressure just like pushing you down. When you make the mindset shift to start looking at those same circumstances, those same situations, and instead of putting the blame outward, you look at what lessons you can learn, how you can build your character, and what you can do to overcome those obstacles and those challenges, that's when you're taking ownership and authority over those challenges and turning that into a positive. So your positivity count on the other side of your personal account grows and grows and starts depleting the negative blame scale on the other side here. And before you know it, your pile of blame and negative things that are holding you down and holding you back, that bitterness, the unforgiveness, and the pain, you've compensated for that on the other end by persevering, by learning, by growing. And before you know it, you're gonna see greater things happening in your life, like healthier relationships, happier job situation, and just more peace overall. So in short, stop worrying about what others have done and focus on what you're going to do to change that narrative. Going into this week, let's all strive to be more purposeful rather than perfect, and to find joy in the small things and find encouragement everywhere. Have a great Monday, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.